Hi, and thanks for logging on to the Daily Dvar. Here's a brand new halacha for you, and it's for Sunday, the 19th day of February. Here we go. Today's halacha is about Havdalah and the Besamim that you smell at Havdalah. The purpose of the Besamim at Havdalah is because our Neshama Yaseira, that extra soul that comes to us for the day of Shabbos, leaves us at the end of Shabbos. We feel spiritually lacking, and the Besamim kind of refreshen us at that moment when our Neshama Yaseira, our extra Neshama is soul, is leaving us. And so we smell besamim at that time. Now we only have two hands, and if you're the person who's leading the Havdalah and you have a cup of wine in your right hand, how do you work this? Well, first of all, I got to tell you that the besamim container should be opened before the beginning of Havdalah, like we always do with brachas. We have them ready to go for right after the bracha. You could go right to it. So therefore, it is most appropriate to have the besamim container open. Don't sniff it until it's time, but have it open so that it's ready. Then, when you get to the bracha for besamim, the appropriate thing to do is to take the wine cup out of your right hand, put it in your left hand, and have it remain there while you do the brachas on the besamim and also on the candle. Take the besamim in your right hand now that the cup is in your left hand. Not all poskim say that. Some of the rabbis say that it's okay to put the cup down on the table during the besamim and the havdalah, but the more prevalent custom seems to be to have the cup of wine in your left hand. Now, you should not use stuff like air freshener or cheap perfumes. It's most appropriate that it's be something that has like a substance to it, like cloves or cinnamon or stuff like that, so that there's some besamim, some herbs right there, not some just cheap senses that are trapped in a bottle. But you could speak to your rabbi if you have any particular ones that you'd like to use. And the general rule is that whatever kind of besamim you're using, you should make the bracha of Borei Minei Besamim regardless of whether it's this kind of besamim or that kind of besamim. Although I should just say to you that if you're using anything really outlandish, speak to your rabbi just to make sure that it qualifies as a besamim for Havdalah. Thanks for logging on. Log on again tomorrow for more. Bye-bye.